beautiful knots that are swirling all over the place and look like hair. I get really excited to try and like match the knots up so it looks like eyes. Like walking into the studio every day knowing that like I've got all these emails from people that are like, where's my artwork? I can't wait to have it. And that's my job. I'm going back and forth creating what is going to be special to them, and I get pictures of their dogs and their kids and like where it's going to go and like what they like to do, if they like to go like mountain climbing or be at the beach, and then the final product becomes even more special to these clients of mine. And that's also so beautiful when I get their response back for things that I make for them. Yes. I grew up in front of the ocean, which is always in front of the ocean, visiting it, always sitting in front of it, and it's just my place to process and feel inspired and feel humbled and all of the emotions, the full spectrum of all of them. But then the desert, there's something really powerful about the desert. Most particularly like all of Utah and all those national parks in Utah and Joshua Tree, and I feel it in my entire body, and I feel grounded, and each breath feels significant and important. And so those themes are always coming back into my work, and I'm always kind of taken to places while I'm creating. And now with this whole age of putting yourself on the internet, being able to talk about and be that dark side of yourself, being vulnerable about the shit that I've been going through, I have made so many beautiful relationships and connections with people because I've decided to just be myself and be myself who I am now. And it's sometimes it's kind of ugly, and that's totally cool and even more beautiful than like putting a smile on your face. The day by day currently in life is what I'm just doing. It's that, you know, just feeling everything that is the day and taking it in. Professionally, I just want to keep going bigger. I want to travel with it. I want to get flown out to Spain and be able to be there for 2 months and create a massive piece of artwork. Bigger is what my goal is. I was told to never stop making, and that hit me because at the time, like, I was still swimming around in what I wanted to do. And you just keep making, even when it's total shit, you're gonna find what it is that you love, and you're gonna find what it is that you can potentially be good at and then master. It's gonna be, you know, shades of beige. I'm very inspired by all shades of beige right now, very monochromatic. Currently, right now, everything is like the color of the desert in my mind, in my house, in how I dress. Like, that's definitely gonna be present, and it's gonna be a jacket you're gonna wanna be in the desert in. They call me the lover. I just don't like red.
Really?
I never bring like red into my artwork. I mean, I love, you know, like, a red shirt or a sweatshirt, I guess, or like hat.
I sound like it. I guess I like a red shirt.
But, I mean, I've had people want me to put like red into artwork, and I'm just always like, I don't want to do it.